What are you gonna do? 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 I think the story of compassion is an amazing story of what God can do when one person is willing to be obedient to what God lays on his heart. Let me explain. You gotta go way back. It's an amazing heritage we have, but it began with one man. His name was Everett Swanson. He was a pastor and evangelist in Chicago. He was invited to go speak to the troops in Korea during the conflict. And he had never been out of the country, and Korea was the other side of the world. He was far, far from home. And although it's an amazing, noble story now, it didn't begin so noble. It began with a petty theft. Everett Swanson, in one of his first days in the country, a little boy from the street grabbed his winter coat and ran off with it. And being a man from Chicago and accustomed to crime, well, he chased the little guy. And the little guy ran around the corner, and when Everett finally rounded the corner, a little huffing and puffing, the little boy was gone. But there was his coat lying in the doorway of one of the shops, along with a bunch of rags. And he thought, well, the little guy must have just thrown it there and ran even faster without it. So he went to pick up his coat, and what he discovered when he picked up his winter coat was the face of a frightened little boy huddling underneath it. And he was a thin little boy, his teeth were chattering, and next to him, the other rags suddenly came to life as well, and he discovered that here was a whole doorway, a group of little children all huddled underneath these rags, trying to keep warm in the midst of the bitter, bitter cold of Korea. Well, his heart was moved with compassion, I think you can say. And the first thing he did was go back to the restaurant that he had been in, and he got soup, and he came and he gave it to these half a dozen little children that were shivering there in the cold. And he got blankets and did what he could. He couldn't sleep that night. He was troubled. He was praying for the children, and he got up early in the morning before the sun came up. Went back to see how the little ones were. And as he approached the doorway, he discovered something that really troubled him. There was a huge, big truck there, and there were soldiers there. And the soldiers had gone down into the little doorway, and they had shaken each one of these little piles of rags. And they were looking to see who didn't make it through the night. And those that didn't survive were picked up and thrown into the back of the truck and whisked away. And by the time the sun came up in the city of Seoul, Korea, the horror of the night had passed. The children had shared with each other the only thing they had to give to one another, which was their body warmth. But as the truck went on down the road, he realized it's not just this doorway, it's that doorway and that doorway and that doorway. And he discovered from the people that these were the children whose parents had been killed in the war and had no place to go. The only thing they had for each other was their own warmth. The government was overwhelmed with the war. It was a poverty-stricken nation. The church virtually didn't exist back in those days. There was only 400,000 Christians in all of South Korea. Well, his time there was just a short few days in Korea as he preached to the troops, led many of them to Christ, if I remember Everett Swanson properly. But it was time to go, and he climbed on the airplane to head back to Chicago. And as this big man of God, with his heart so broken and so full, climbed on that plane to fly back, the engines began to drone in his ear, and then they began to form rhythms in his ear, and then they began to form words in his ear. And what he was hearing as he flew along was, so what are you gonna do? 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 He listened to that all the way back through, and when he got to Chicago, he knew that he had to do something. One of the very first things he did was tell one of his friends about what he had seen, the horror of it all, these frightened little frozen children. And his friend said, Everett, and he opened the drawer of his desk and he pulled out a check for $1,000, no name filled on it, just a check for $1,000. And he said, you know, a long time ago, God told me, I want you to care for the orphans and for the widows in the world. So when someone comes and tells you about that need, give it. And he says, Everett, I'm giving it to you. So Everett Swanson, obedient to those engines, what are you going to do? The first person he told about it gave him $1,000, and Compassion International was born. He listened to the engines, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? What are you going to do? That was more than 50 years ago. The question for us today is, what are we going to do?
What are you going to do?